the inclusion of the House of Anubis Season 3 intro, even though this is a movie.
This is graduation day, Anubis style.
Narration.
We've got the caps.
No one is wearing caps in this entire sequence.
We've got the Egyptian god Ra raining down his anger.
Lightning is not rain.
Why is it always Egypt?
What we have always been wondering since season one.
And that concludes your final lesson.
Scores down!
That was not a lesson. Also, disrupting classroom on the last day of school cliche. These kids that you completely dislike are graduating in a few days, and yet you still are mean and angrily yell at them. Wait, don't yell, or else you'll look... Oh, wait.
Who are you?
I'm Erin.
I'm Cassie.
Discount Amber and Mara? Check.
Marshmallow frittata! Should I eat it? Or patent it?
Discount? Every boy in the history of the show? Check. Also, I don't think your frittata can survive a rigorous patenting process without getting spoiled.
Trudy, there's a stranger in the kitchen.
Dexter. But you can call me Dex.
Introducing yourself doesn't make you no longer a stranger. For all we know, you could still be in here to rob the place.
Middle school's got bed bugs.
Bed bugs? Isn't this a health code violation?
Oh, sure. Take her home on field trip. What's next, our lives?
Joy's convenient foreshadowing. It's not nice to rape your hand in someone else's sleeve, right? Where are your manners, mister?
Fabian, you coming? I don't get it. I work hard. I ace every test. Save the world a few times.
Look, no, he didn't save the world. True, the cup of ink only took a life when someone drank the elixir of life from it. And Sikara threatened your lives in season 2. But the only device with worldwide consequences was the Staff of Osiris. You fell for Robert's trick and even tried to stop KT, Eddie, and Harriet from destroying the staff in the finale. So no, you never saved the world.
Yeah, but I wrote the best speech. You had this killer Georgie gag on page 49.
Wait, there's a page 49 on your valedictory speech? It's not even halfway through the speech? By the time you will get done with the speech, it'll be time to start the next class's graduation.
Hi, I...
Discount Lena Martin? Check. The House of Anubis second generation spinoff is a go, people.
Hey, whoa!
You okay?
Yeah, thanks. My hero.
No, he'd only be a hero to your head. He wouldn't have died from slipping on the frittata. Only get a slight headache.
What is that? Another stray?
Giving the newcomers the warmest welcome, are we, Victor?
Anyway, you must be... Mr. Rudenmean.
Rudenma!
Okay, taking a send-off for that bit.
Have we met before, young lady?
No. You're thinking of my American cousin, Nina.
Rick. Right, Vic.
What? No ready remark? No yelling for respect? I'm disappointed.
And FYI, if you want to make it through this week alive, remember that we're the seniors.
And you're the amoebas.
Actually, the pro of amoeba is...
Really?
Actually, according to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, amoebas is one of two acceptable plural forms of amoeba.
Isn't it odd that they only bandaged up the mummies?
What about all the daddies?
Only Willow can get away with a joke like that.
You don't think Willow's having doubts about college with me, right?
Well, she is only human.
Well, that wasn't nice.
You made a big impression today. Victor, I mean...
So embarrassing. He probably hates me now.
He hates everyone. Don't sweat it.
Victor doesn't hate the teachers and staff, though. Unless your last name is Denby. And for that matter, I know Caroline Denby was devoured by Amit and all, but there's literally no record of her being a teacher at the school. And just carry on just like that, without hiring a new teacher? The school board won't stand for this.
This place is so educational.
There's nothing educational about House of Anubis. They don't even get Egyptian mythology 100% right.
They call it the Touchstone of Ra.
Roll credits.
It has powerful magnetic qualities.
That makes two of us.
Wait, are you hitting on a 40-something-year-old security guard? That's just as weird as hitting on Victor.
That's just a fable, though, right?
Fable. A short story, typically with animals as characters, conveying a moral. There are no animals in that legend, and there wasn't really a clear moral. So no, the legend of the Pyramid of Ra is not a fable.
If I had invited a crowd of trespassing delinquents, I'd have remembered.
But delinquents wouldn't be graduating.
Everybody, form a line, now!
A little early for graduation, isn't it?
Wait a minute. Weren't you key fans upset about this graduation thing? Because graduation doesn't occur at the high school level? And this is a British boarding school, so... There's no reason to be passing the stone around. There is no need for you guys to keep hidden, and it will be found eventually. All you're doing is wasting time.
Alfred Lewis.
Told you.
Look, that it wasn't...
Edison, did you take this?
No! It was in my bag, but
if you really expected that your father would have believed you, why would you even have it be passed around? I know I'm saying this three times, but really, the only reason why this happened was for plot convenience later on.
Get out.
Get out!
Victor whispering and then shouting cliche.
Victor? What is it? Destiny.
In season 1 and 2, becoming immortal was your destiny. In season 3, reawakening Robert Frobisher Smythe was your destiny. How could one man, let alone the reason a school was founded, have three different destinies?
The stone is not here.
Okay, I've seen this movie dozens of times. Spoiler alert, I know Victor isn't really trying to build the Pyramid of Ra. But what I'm confused about is how does the house not know that, but know whether it's the Chosen One or the Assyrian that is using Sarah's locket.
In 5 minutes precisely, I shall want to hear a pin drop.
He actually said it. That's his catchphrase.
But how would you know, Dexter? Is House of Anubis like an in-universe reality show? And if so, who on earth would believe any of this Egyptian mythology stuff would be real?
Spends most nights down here, brewing potions, gassing butterflies, dressing dead.
Joy's account is the only one that is accurate, and for good reason. She was down there with the Secret Society during season 1.
Jerome!
That was just done for season 1 nostalgia purposes.
It's probably going to be looking for Sophia. Patricia, the easiest way to lose a guy is to be possessive and jealous. Jerome? Here, now.
Jerome Mercer's love tutorials. Do as I say, not as they do.
In the name of Ra, I come to collect the touchstone and my revenge on this house.
Wait, is she like the Ra-ian?
Sophia?
Oh, Eddie, thank goodness, what is that?
Is she possessed by Ra now? If so, how is she still able to keep her free will? No one cares about evil laugh impersonations.
Ah, the lights are back on. Perfect timing.
Yeah, too perfect.
Victor wants to build the pyramid to get all the gold?
But he has to sacrifice someone first. Would Victor really do that?
For all the gold of Ra, he might.
This is a private conversation.
Am I the only one who remembers Victor's reaction when Rufusino told him about the true nature of the scales of life and off he pretended to die? He even sacrificed what he thought was the last tier of gold to save Joy. How am I the only one here, besides Patricia, who knows that Victor would not willingly sacrifice anyone?
This is a private conversation, Agent Pigtails.
Sophia is not wearing pigtails, though.
And I can totally keep a secret.
You're already good at keeping your own.
You're welcoming Sophia into some secret society! What, Sabuna?
No. One of Sabuna's goals was to stop the secret society, not form another one.
Boy, are we recruiting today? Did somebody place an ad?
Okay, taking another send off for that gig.
your secret club except me and Joy.
Actually, Joy knows.
Rita brushed off that the only reason she knows is because of her whole disappearance storyline from season one.
Fine. Have your secrets. I'm going to the police about the stolen artifact.
No. I know about your fears of the police and all, Sabuna, but do you really think that they would allow Victor to keep a stone to complete some old legend that requires a human sacrifice? Sergeant Roebuck isn't even helping Victor anymore.
I have spent the last 3 summers photographing fairies. Surely I can manage a photo of my classmate.
Taking a photograph of a mythological creature, I don't think makes you the most qualified for a class photo. However, I would pay for photographic proof of the existence of fairies. But I'm doubtful.
No!
Why the heck are you not screaming no? You freaked out when Nina stole the ink piece in season one.
No. No!
And those children will get a graduation that they will never forget.
True, but they won't forget it because of the person you sacrificed, not because of Ra raining down gold.
You need to talk to Sophia. She has an alibi. Me.
Alibi. A claim or piece of evidence that one was elsewhere when an act, typically a criminal one, is alleged to have taken place. So while your claim is an alibi, you yourself are not.
What's he got in his hands?
It's a canopic jar.
Wait, how do you know that? Isn't that suspicious knowledge?
Yeah, the first letter of each line spells a message.
Okay, what does it spell?
Mufinta. Muffin top.
I don't think that a newspaper would deliberately spell out a word on each line, let alone something useless like muffin top.
Someone wrote them out while leaning on that clipping.
Leaning on the clipping? Yeah, that's totally where I was going with it as well.
No, you weren't.
Key to the estate. Kind of a long story. My Graham's family built this place.
Wow, you're a Frobisher?
Wait. Katie's last name is Rush. And you only knew from Victor's account that Robert Frobisher Smythe once owned the house, not built it. Yet you immediately know that KT is a Frobisher. I swear, the only reason Sophia can con Sabina so easily is because no one is asking the right freaking question at the right darn time.
And for the large holes in the front lawn!
Mutant moles?
Now no one would believe that cover.
You stole that stone, didn't you? Patricia and Dexter are right, you're the one who framed me!
Such a worthwhile field trip.
So you're telling me that the clearly obvious bad guy is the obvious bad guy? The next bit is only a sin if you listen to only the dialogue. It makes it sound like Eddie was cheating on Patricia with a freshman.
We let you in. I trusted you! Say goodbye to your pyramid, Sophia!
You really thought that would work? All these artifacts are indestructible. That's like a classic House of Anubis unwritten rule.
For once, your timing is perfect. Per ec useres em wasse. Find sweet and bring me that jar.
Now we have discount sinners. This is like trying to roll every season of the show into one 90-minute movie.
Dexter! Put that back.
You should know you can't fight sinners. That didn't work with Robert and his sinners.
You idiot! Where's the rest?
Somehow the sinner-esque hypnosis isn't enough for him to know that the lid of the jar alone isn't what Sophia wanted. Don't call it a discount for nothing.
Nobody can resist the stone's control.
Yeah, well, you're not the only one with a secret identity.
You don't know Sophia's true identity yet. All you know is that she was playing you. That in and of itself is not a secret identity.
Eddie? What happened?
The hypnosis wears off at the most convenient times.
He and Sophia have disappeared.
You better watch that.
Are you trying to get Patricia to pour a drink all over you?
Guess you're looking for a date tonight.
You know, since he and Willow fizzled out.
Cassie!
Well, that was rude.
So, I'm your sidekick now?
No, no, you're the valedictorian. And I'm the hieroglyph guy.
Well, that was even more rude.
Don't you want to feel like a princess?
Patricia is not the kind of girl who ever wants to feel like a princess. Cat fight, get... Oh, wait. Nickelodeon wouldn't allow that to happen on screen during a kid's TV show.
And why are you dressed like a bridesmaid?
What, someone getting married?
The next person who mentions this loses their teeth.
I bet she really won't injure anyone.
Maybe she's Mrs. Alchemist.
You really think that an alchemist who's all grown up would go out with a teenager? That's just sad. Apparently pickpocketing is okay when he's stealing something back from someone evil. So, Ed is able to sneak through the tunnels to change for Founder's Day in the season finale, but he can't hear.
This dress, what are you trying to do, rescue us or catch a bouquet?
Told you she wouldn't. Kiki Girl is so interested in a new place, familiar to the audience, that she looks around longer than she should, cliche.
That stone is my destiny.
Not falling for it this time.
Seriously, does it take a chandelier to fall on him for you guys to believe Victor is on your side? Two walls coming together, cliche.
Quick, through the window!
Very convenient.
We have to get this as far away from Sophia and the house as possible! Eddie!
This is way cooler than middle school, right?
High school isn't as thrilling as the show makes it seem.
Ethically sourced wild silk from Madagascar, actually.
Clearly, this isn't eco-friendly.
So, we're on the same side as Victor. Pinch me.
Wanting to save Alfie from dying. Actually saving Joy from dying. Helping Nina defeat Rufus and Sankara. I could go on and on about how Victor helping Sabuna isn't new.
Sabuna!
Riguna reference.
It's a bit dirty. Ooh!
Now, I'm not gonna drink from that.
Alright, I'm gonna make you all honorary members of Sabuna.
Separating from the group is just for plot convenience.
Which means Ra will destroy the world.
Destroying the world is very much like Season 3. Increased danger just for the sake of increased danger.
I have got it. I just... Not on my person at this precise moment.
That's a weird way to put it.
Have you checked the tunnels?
Not in this outfit.
That line was probably meant for Amber before she was written out of House of Unity.
They should not be here.
Now is not the time for your silly rules.
Hello people, it's supposed to be the best day of our lives.
And why do you all look like the world's about to end?
Jeroy foreshadowing. Wait, if KT wasn't hypnotized with Sophia summoning the other stones, why didn't she just run and warn someone? So, the Siren can now build new stones at will?
The house. It's talking to me again. I didn't know you guys fell out.
Is everything romantic with Dexter?
Congratulations, Mara. Congratulations!
Did it take you that long for you to realize that Mara is now in danger?
Mara, tell him to give it to me! I thought we'd agreed.
You are not the valedictorian, Fape, and Mara is so in student parlance. Duh, get over it!
Seriously, how can anyone else not interpret this as anything else?
Think about what you're doing!
It's all I've thought about for the last 100 years.
That does it. Sophia is a discount Nina Martin gone rogue.
Where is everyone going?
Seriously, Jerome and Joy, you may mock them for it, but you must remember the existence of Sabuna.
When I was a child, my father told me that my destiny was to prevent the Pyramid of Ra from ever being built.
Victor's destiny isn't to become immortal? When did that change?
No! No!
You may have stopped the sacrifice, but now the world ends. Great choice, Osirian.
The Osirian will give his life so that the world may be spared. You must destroy it.
So, you're willing to just give up your life? Just like that?
The Osirian may be dead, but the boy lives.
So what about his powers?
Gone.
So you're telling me that the power to use an ancient Egyptian locket and talk to an old house is worth more to Ra than the whole world, and not turning anyone to stone while allowing the boy to live? This is just BS. Or worse, teaching them that those powers are worth more than a human life. Great morals, writers.
Over here.
That stone statue is too small for me to believe that it's Sophia turned to stone. Also, I bet the orange glow, Eddie surviving near death, and a stone statue that looks just like a weeping angel were only done as Doctor Who references.
And my advice to all you alumni is go party! Like this is the last day of your lives.
Very bad timing. You should have changed your ending after knowing what all transpired. Discount Season 1 memories.
I shall leave Anubis' house and take it with me.
Wait, you're leaving Anubis' house?
They make Victor leave without getting Sophia's elixir supply? That's completely out of character. They make this you the nicest person in all the series.
Miscreants.
They're bidding you goodbye and then you still make a mean remark? That's the worst last line that a character in the show has ever said.
Nothing like a near apocalypse to put stuff into perspective.
How do you know that? No! Phoebe and Chippers look away! I'd rather see Jamie than this weird couple.
Guys? We just graduated, so let's celebrate.
Aww. I wanted to see KT dance with a tree stump.
Well, I could make an exception for a superhero.
Well, I'm not anymore.
Eddie is upset that he's alive without his power. Be grateful you get a chance to live your life, Eddie. We're not sure how to run this, so let's just show the Anubis house poster. Wait, evil person welcomed into Sabrina at first. Only one person refuses to trust them. And the inclusion of secondary characters that are the new Anubis House residents. This clearly is Head House Anubis and Detective Von Sibuna, butchered and made more dramatic like only the House of Anubis writers could do.
But I wrote the best speech.
Wait, salmon! Trout! Oh, help! Get me out of here! Help!
And that concludes your final lesson.
School's down!
What time is it? Summertime. It's our vacation. What time is it? Party time.
What has happened? The graduation is just falling apart.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine?
What the? Who are you?
I'm Turbo, the greatest racer ever.
Stupid. No! He's alive.
If the witch knew the true meaning of sacrifice, she might have interpreted the deep magic differently.
But that letter you sent to Mr. Sweet?
Never heard of him.
I had to use hotel staff to round up the rabble your children unleashed on this hotel.
So I'm gonna turn into a statue.
I told you
jet!
Today we're going to show you how to make picture frames out of old junk. Rebecca R. of Whitman, Massachusetts emailed us this idea.
Eric. Sarah M. Wasser.
Now we are.
What the?
I don't want to go.
You could gaze into the future.
Fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher.
Hey, cock-a-doodle-doo, the cow says moo! Cock-a-doodle-doo, the cow pays moo!
Station, Stacy Jones speaking. How can
Stacey,
I?
Stacy,
not now. Can't you see I'm on the phone?
Out on the verge of the rest of our lives tonight. Top of the world, and we're dressed to the nines tonight.
Okay, admit it. It's you, isn't it? You're the one who's hanging up those smear flyers about me.
What are you talking about?
You know I'm running for president.
Look, I just transferred here.
Okay. What is going on here? Victor is talking about. You're welcoming Sophia into some. What?
Boy, are we recruiting today? Did somebody place an ad?
It all sounded pretty weird to me, too.
And you've only been here 5 minutes! Does everybody know about your except me and Joy?
I'd like to make myself believe this planet Earth turns slow.
It seems the paranoid are sometimes actually being followed.
This film is only for Madagascar and Iran, neither of which accept American copyright or trademark law.